You know, let me say, you come across a lot of people when you run a presidential campaign. And you come across people who pretend to be your friends. You come across people who say they were there from day one. You come across people who picked up the winning lottery ticket the day after you won the election and said that they were wrong with that in their hand. You come across people you can trust and you want to stand next to. What I learned in this presidential campaign is there's very few people, when times get tough, that you rely on, that would be there for you, not because they wanted something, because it was the right thing to do. This is my first trip, I'll tell you, the first trip I have taken since the president has been elected or since I've left the campaign on behalf of any candidate for office anywhere. And the reason for that is I know a winner when I see one. I saw one with Donald Trump the day I walked into his office and he told me he wanted to be the president of the United States when nobody told me he could do it, and he couldn't run, and he couldn't win, and he'd never file his forms, and he'd never be successful, and the field was too big and too broad, and no one was going to take him seriously. We went through all of that. And now I know a winner living in Georgia. And I'm here for Bruce for one reason. Because Donald Trump needs a friend in Congress. Because when it comes to Congress, there's a lot of people there who say, I was with you, Mr. President, when we know they weren't. There's a lot of people who say, Mr. President, I'm here to support your agenda, but guess what, I can't help you on this one. There's a lot of people who say, hey, I want to put the country in the right direction, but on my terms and not what you ran on, Mr. President. Because what the president ran on was reforming health care, repealing and replacing Obamacare, cutting taxes, making sure that the average American has more money in their pocket, reducing trade deficits. We've got $20 trillion in deficit right now, and our numbers continue to go through the roof. If the president doesn't have people of core convictions in Congress that are going to support his agenda, which is the agenda he ran on, then he's not going to be successful. And what we know and what we saw last week was there are some Republicans who supported the president's agenda and some who didn't. We know that we'll never get into the Democrats. It doesn't matter if it's the most perfect bill in the history of, you know, Alexander Hamilton himself could come write the bill, or George Washington himself, they wouldn't get a Democrat to support it. Congress has been fundamentally broken for 30 years. Republicans and Democrats alike have gone there and lied to you. They told you they're going to fix it, they didn't do it. And for the first time in my lifetime, we now have a candidate who sits in the Oval Office, who is not beholden to 30 years of Washington dogma, that is not stuck on being bought and paid for by the Washington special interests and their political action committees, that takes a businessman's perspective to the Oval Office, that's going to fundamentally change Washington, D.C. And what you have in front of you tonight is you have a candidate who has a business background, a person who understands what it's like to make a payroll, not live off the government, a person who understands that the government can't continue to spend more than they make. Bruce understands this. Bruce understands what it's like to have to go start a business and run a business and be successful, the ups and the downs, and what the government's punitive action can do against small businesses, whether it's the Department of Labor or the EPA or all these other government agencies that have run amok against our citizens. It's time to have people in Congress who understand that they're given a privilege of going to Congress to serve their people, but the power is derived from the people. What I think we need in Washington, D.C. is something brand new. Like Donald Trump has said and campaigned on congressional term limits, and people say, well, term limits are when you go to the ballot box, but the problem is, the power of the incumbency is so strong and so powerful that most of these people get in there, they live in pine boxes because it's the greatest job they'll ever have. Congress wasn't designed to go there and spend 20, 30, 40, 50 years living off the government. It's supposed to be a citizen legislature where people go and they do their job for a period of time, they go back to their districts, they go back to the job they had before. And they try and make a change. That's what Bruce wants to do. Let's go to Washington to carry forward the change which the president has brought there. And the only way to do that is to defy the odds. Look, we ran a campaign that was an outsider's campaign, which was a campaign where, you know, we didn't embrace the Republican establishment because we weren't the Republican establishment. We ran against governors and senators and former elected officials and you know, a few business executives. They all told us, you know what, we weren't good enough, smart enough, and we couldn't move forward. We didn't have the best campaign. We didn't have the most talented campaign team. But one by one by one, all those candidates in the primary fell by the wayside because they had the wrong message. Their message was, I'm from Washington, I can fix it. We don't need that anymore. Those days are over. And I think what we've seen is that the American people have decided to embrace change. Bruce is that change. Georgia's going to have a very unique opportunity here very shortly. Early voting has already started. Special elections are very, very difficult because the turnout is exceptionally low. You have an extremely divided field in this particular race, which tells you that the ability to get a small number of votes is more important than ever. You're here. You've taken time out of your day, out of your finances to support this campaign, but it's not enough. If you haven't already voted, you have to start. You have to go vote. You have to tell your neighbors and bring them along. Because early voting is so critical. What I've been told is that the Democrats' early voting numbers are through the roof already, right? They are engaged. The Democrats are fully engaged to do anything they can to stop the Trump agenda. They will do anything. They will lie, they will cheat, they will steal, they will do anything they can because they are so desperate right now. And what we know is our only ability to move our agenda forward, which is smaller government, lower taxes, less regulation, no more punitive action against small businesses, giving the resources to the small businesses to grow, helping small business owners go from a 1 to 2 and 5 person company to a 10 and 20 and 50 person company, repeal and replace Obamacare. The only way that happens is if we put people in Congress who understand what it's like to be a small business owner or a business owner because they met that payroll. And that's what Bruce brings. Look, career politicians are perfectly fine people, but they've never solved anything. This is the problem that you're faced with. And that's not a disparaging or pejorative comment against any one candidate who's in this race or may not be in this race. I don't believe in career politicians. I support a candidate who hadn't run for office until he was 69 years old. And you know what they said when we ran against Jeb Bush? Well, he's a little rusty. He hadn't run in about 8 years. Because my guy hadn't run in 69, he's really rusty, except we would kill him, right? That's the difference. So, look, it's really, really a privilege for me to come down here. And while I'm honored by the opportunity to come, and maybe I get this crazy accent so you guys can't really understand what I'm saying right now, the real thing is, I wouldn't be here if it wasn't for Bruce. On good times in this campaign, and bad times in this campaign, when we set up the Diversity Coalition, Bruce's wife came up to New York with us. When we needed a surrogate to go on television to combat these egregious accusations that the president is a racist, when we wanted someone who knew, because they had private conversations with Donald Trump, what the man was like, as opposed to the public persona, we never had to call Bruce more than once to go on TV. He was always a steadfast supporter, always there, telling the truth when the mainstream media wanted to portray candidate Trump as something that he wasn't. It's a hard thing to do, particularly when you get a lot of arrows, and you get a lot of people accusing you of things now because you've put your name and your reputation in front of the American people, in front of the media, and then you're accused of things which aren't very helpful to you or your family or your business when you're a small business owner. But every single time Bruce was asked, and many times when he wasn't asked, and many times when we didn't give him the talking points to go on television, he went on TV and defended the president, or talked about the president, talked about his agenda, or supported his agenda, and every time we asked Bruce to come to a rally, he'd be at that rally, and he'd make sure the rally was perfect, and every time we came to Georgia, he was there. He was a friend from the beginning of the campaign. And I can tell you, when we started the campaign, we didn't have a lot of friends. So it's amazing as we get closer to the end, we get more and more friends. Now we have a lot of friends. It's amazing, right? A lot of friends. Like 90% of them want a job, which is kind of crazy, right? But they all tell me they were there from day one. But look, I know the truth because I was the person who turned the lights on the building when we started this project. And I know who was there and who wasn't there. Bruce. Bruce was there. And if I can ask you one thing, I ask you to not only vote for Bruce, because it's very important for me that he shows up in Congress and represents the values that he brings in his family and small business and to represent Georgia's 6th District. It's very important. But you need to bring in friends. You have to understand races are hard. They're hard on families, they're hard on friends. But it's the individuals who do the extra step. Now, Donald Trump campaigned in 4 time zones and did 5 different rallies leading up to Election Day while Hillary Clinton was taking a nap. It makes a difference. Every campaign event makes a difference. And if the last event that we did in the state of Michigan didn't occur at 1 o'clock in the morning, I don't know if Donald Trump would have won Michigan that day. He won by the smallest of margins. Every event makes a difference. It is really hard. You've got a special election where turnout's going to be really low. You have to double down. You need to bring your friends out, your family out. You have to explain to them what is truly at stake in this election. And what's at stake is, do we want to continue to move the country in the right direction? For the first time, if you can believe this, since 2009, a public poll says the country's actually going in the right direction. Think of that. We need a Congress which is going to move in the right direction. Congress is going to support the president's agenda, and we're going to have that Congress, and Bruce LeVell is there to make sure that we can support the president's agenda. So I ask you, I beg you, I implore you, not only vote for Bruce LeVell, help him financially, tell your friends, make sure they vote, vote early, make sure that they understand when this election is coming. Special elections are so difficult. There will be people who have more money, happen to us. Almost every candidate in the race has more money than we had in the race. We ran it lean and efficient, like a business operation would be. When I walked in tonight, I saw Bruce's team was lean and efficient, on point everywhere we go. That's what we expect in our campaign, that's what I see in this campaign. So I ask you, go out, get your friends, remind them election day is coming. Vote early, vote absentee, whatever it may be, but please, please, please support Bruce LeVell because we need him in Congress. Thank you very much.
Thank you. I think we can do better than that. Let's let Courtney know. Courtney, we appreciate you being here.